members of the channel, what's going on? Shout out to T Smith. This is one of those videos that, you know, many of y'all enjoy. Thank the members down below. I was like, what's going on? Like, T Smith slipping? I don't know. I didn't get a notification. 2 weeks ago, we could have had a Q&A 2 weeks ago, but hey, everything happens when it's supposed to happen. So we're going to get into this. If you're wondering how to make videos like this possible, see that join button down below? Hey, I appreciate you. How I get into it now? How y'all doing out there? It is election day. I'm off. It's 9:12. You know, I'm just trying to get some things done before I go out. I said, you know, I was just going to call. I said, oh, man, you know, I'm a little away. I was like, this would be a good time to do the Q&A. I get it. Away Q&A. Sorry for the delay. I did not know. I did not see these questions. Wait, hold on. Because it was in a reply to something. So that's why I didn't, yeah. But anyhow, neither here nor here. Read more. Yeah, 2 weeks ago, I'm like, T. Smith slipping. And no, T. Smith's not the only member, but the other members seem to like, you know, the questions she brings. And so they just leave it to her. And I ain't mad, yo. So how many questions we got? Oh, shit. We got 15 questions. Let's go. With these videos, I don't really edit much. Let's let it go. So let's go. If, number one, if you ever feel discriminated against, would you defend yourself or not address it? It all depends. It all depends on the situation. It all depends. I'm trying to think of a situation. Well, the last situation I had, I don't know, discriminate. I can't say I've experienced that, you know, any kind of discriminate, you know, blatantly, you know, to my face. I don't know what's going on. But late, I was trying to think of, but the overall, if I ever, would I defend myself? Yes, because I have in the past, you know, if I felt, you know, yeah. I was trying to think of that, nothing recent, yeah. Number two, has your ego or your partner's ego ever gotten in the way of your relationship? Now, ego, a person's sense of self-esteem or self-importance. Yes, it has. Ego is a person's sense of self-esteem or self-importance. Yes, it has. On both ends. Yes, it has. I think everyone experiences that, and yeah, it has. Okay, I have to get back to my questions. Number three, are there any experiences you wish you would have had as a child or during your high school years? You know, actually, yeah. Well, like, I'll say high school years. And I wasn't, like, real. Well, I'm still not I guess you'd call me, I'm not a social butterfly. I'm not into crowds and lots of people. But I do wish, you know, that I just recently, you know, when I recently, my, you know, my nephew, when he did his whole prom and stuff. I wish I had experienced that. I, like, went to that, did that. But again, I wasn't really into that kind of thing. But then I look back at his experience and I'm like, it would have been cool to have, you know, prom. And then what they have, like, they go on, did I go on a senior trip? I can't even remember, but yeah, stuff like that, but nothing really said. Yeah. Number four. Is there anything about the opposite sex that you wish you understood? Mm-hmm. In general, no, but like, okay, when it comes down to, I guess when it comes to bringing to sexuality, I want to know why men are intimidated by women that look like me. Oh, when I say bitch, I'm not being disrespectful. It's a woman. Okay, I don't want your woman. Sorry, my bad. I just want to say, like, the fuck? Why do I intimidate you? Like, girl, bye. I mean, man, bye. Number five. Do you still have any tangible piece of your childhood that you haven't thrown away? No, I don't have anything. No, I don't have anything. I'm just like doing a check. No, I don't. Is that bad? Where am I? Number six. What is the most sentimental gift you have ever received from someone? Sentimental. Sentimental to them or to me? Okay, let me think. Why are you growling, stomach? I drank tea. Most sentimental. See that? Okay, but see, okay, I'm gonna screenshot this so I can just come because I want to go and look at something. Girl, you with these questions? You make it, oh girl, you make me think about some shit. Because I could say what I, okay, sentimental. Of or prompted by feelings of tenderness, sadness, or nostalgia. Oh God, what a question. Wow. That's some shit. I can tell of the sentimental things I have, but don't given to me? Cause cause again, I ask a question: is it sentimental to them or to me? Because I look at myself. I'm not the I'm hard at receiving gifts. That's why it was dope. My birthday just passed. Doing the whole Amazon thing. I put on there what I want, so no one asks what I want. But I'm saying I'm not. It's hard. Well, it's not hard. It's just that my tastes, the things that I like, are expensive. Y'all watch me now. I love cameras. The last I remember, I'm 40, so I think it was 40. 46, 40, I think it was on my 44th birthday when my good friend, close friends Kurt had asked me, what I want for my birthday. And I was like, nah, but he's like, he wanted it. And I told him it was a camera. And he was like, I would never ask. And he don't mean that, I don't mean no shade or nothing like that. But it's just, I know what I like. And I just, no, I'd rather do it for myself. So when it comes to the sentimental part, that's some shit, I can tell you of the things that I've done, but looking back and thinking about, I don't, because again, sentimental. Because again, I'm thinking, is it sentimental to them or is it supposed to be sentimental to me? I don't know if you get what I'm saying. Wow. Because you, okay, you said gift, so it's something, I don't know. Because, okay, this is something tangible. I'm sentimental acts, but gifts? No. Sentimental acts? Yeah, but you ain't asked that. So, ha! Let's go. Yeah, I can't. Gifts? No. But sentimental acts? Yeah, I could, a whole lot. But, Seven. Have you ever missed out on a good thing because you were focused on something else? I believe everything happens in its time. And whatever's for me is for me. So, could I take longer to get to that good thing? Hell yeah. But miss out? No. Because I believe what's for you is for you. It may take you, however long it take you to get there. Yeah, due to your own. Yeah. Number eight. Is there anything that makes you emotional in a good way when it crosses your mind? Yeah. Are you asking me what that is? Well, currently, the most recent is. No. No, you said, is there anything? You ain't asked what? You said, is there anything? You ain't, yeah. Yes, there is. Shit. Moving on. Number nine. We still recording? Make sure this shit. Are we still recording? Yeah. This one got. Oh, okay. Make sure it's recording. The red light records blending with the background. Where am I? Is it da-da-da? Number nine. What is something you always want people to remember about you when you're gone? Now. I'm assuming, are you saying when I'm dead? Well, you didn't say when I'm dead. You said when I'm gone. So is that you mean when I leave the room? What is something you always want people to remember about you? Okay, I'm gonna take this like just when if I leave the person's presence. So yeah, I'm not taking this as I'm dead. Something I always want a person to remember when I'm gone. Let me see how I can put this. Just because I'm quiet, don't say much. don't think I'm not observing. I don't know if that makes any sense. I'm just trying to keep it as clear as, yeah. Don't take my kindness for weakness. That part too. Yeah. Number 10. Can you think of a moment in your lifetime that would, make a good love song? Yeah, boom. It's moments that I'm having right now. Hell yeah. Yeah. 11. If you can remember it, what was the last song you danced to? I don't dance. I mean, I've danced in the shower. It's Afro beats music. I don't know. There's a lot of songs, but like, I'm not a dancer. So, but yeah, particular song, I don't have one. I just be dancing in the shower to music. Thank you, Crystal. Number 12. What do you think is the worst thing that could happen to you while you are on a date? You said worst thing. I'm gonna give a couple of the worst thing. You could call the person the wrong name. Well, for me, I could get the shits. My system is regular, and you know, if I had to use the bathroom, I have to get the runs. No, that's the worst thing that happened on a date. Oh, the worst. I was about to say you don't like the person in person, but no, I wouldn't go on a date because I'd have to like you in person too. But then the worst thing happened on a date. Well, no, the worst thing happened on a date, the person ain't who you thought they was. The worst thing that happened on a date, while on a date. Yeah, I think that's the worst thing. You know, you just, the chemistry is off. Yeah, it's just off. It's not the person, because again, I don't know which date this is. If it's the first date, yeah, I'm going to leave it at, I'm going to use it as it's the first date with somebody. The chemistry is off. It wasn't what you thought it was going to be. I don't know if that, hopefully that answers the question. I don't know. Number 13. Could you fire someone you are friends with if it was your job? Hell yeah. Yo, when it comes to business and friendship and that, the two can mix if there's a respect and if you gotta know there's a boundary. There's a point where we ain't friends, this is business. So yeah, I could. Mm-hmm. For sure. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Number 14. What is one mistake you've made that you've learned from? I'm learning. It's not a mistake. It's just, I don't know. It's not a mistake. Well, oh God. These are mistakes. I have to think of something happened. Okay. Because what I was going to say is, see, expectations is not a mistake, but I'm learning to work on my expectations. I don't know if that's making sense to the question. But it's not a mistake. So I got, okay. What is one mistake you've made that you've learned from? I don't know. I think I sound like a broken record, but it is what it is. When someone tells you who they are, believe them. Yeah, I'm just wanting to keep it there. Number 15. Last but not least. Would you rather see your future or relive your past? Oh, no. Mm-mm. See my future. Yeah, see my future. I mean, the past isn't bad. You know, the past wasn't bad. You know, good and bad, but not to, you know, so it could mean saying I don't want to relive the past. Oh God, I don't know. It's just, all right, been there, done that. Let's go forward. Anyway, y'all, shout out to the members of the channel, especially T Smith, for making videos like this possible. I appreciate you so much. I hope y'all enjoy this. Again, thank the members of this channel for making videos like this possible. Y'all are amazing. Until the next one, I'm out.